Sahanavavatu, sahanau bhunaktu, sahaviryam karavavahai, tejasvinavadhitamastu mavidvishavahai. Om shanti shanti shantihi. Om, may Brahman protect us. May it nourish us. May we work in harmony with great vigor. May our study be illuminating. May we not cherish ill feeling towards each other. Om, peace, peace, peace. Welcome to the Vivekachudamani class today. And we just finished Jivan Mukti Lakshanani, how a person of realization lives in the world without any bondage, without any anxiety, and with always the peace that exists, that free soul, already having realized that soul is Atman and not this body or mind, is different from the nature that the person is associated with. Feels like he is associated or she is associated with this body, mind, this nature. But in reality, it is distinct, it is witness, it has nothing to do with the nature, Atma and Anatma. That's how jnana goes. Sri Ramakrishna says that is the path for knowledge. Knowledge will make you realize that I am the soul, I am the self, which is pure and perfect, and which is not mixed with this universe, this creation. Creation is just like a dream or superimposed something. It is not in itself a reality. The reality, unchanging reality, is only my Atman. And Sri Ramakrishna says, this is jnana, no doubt, that you know that Atman is separate from the soul. And he says that it's like going to roof by the step, knowing that step or the stair is not the roof. This is the stair, so step by step you go ahead, you go forward. This is not roof, this is not roof, this is not roof, and you finally reach roof. So roof is different and stairs are different. Jnani realizes that roof is this, it is all open, you see everything, it's a wonderful view, you get fresh air. But there is stairs, they say, even beyond the jnani. Sri Ramakrishna's language, that is called vijnani. When there is no question of anatma, there is the question of same being, same Atma being perceived as this nature, as this creation. The creation is just the perception of the same Atma. So the reality is this creation, how does it happen? Where does it come from? If there is no basis of this, it is totally negated, then why do we see it? How do we perceive it? Because we perceive Atman through the intellect. Pure intellect, this satyetu agreya buddhya, it can be perceived. The Vedanta would like to say that you have to refine your intellect, purify your intellect, go on thinking on what you have heard about the truth, that's called shruti, and now you do mananam shruti, then yukti or mananam, or go on thinking of what you have heard. What about that? Go on, put logic, negate that, accept that, and finally all logic will put you, if you are pure and you have done a lot of thinking on what you have heard, lot of mananam done, then you become convinced that what you have heard is true. That Atman is the reality, everything else changes. So from that realization, if myself is the unchanging reality, which is not touched by disease, age, birth, death, attachment, misery, nothing is there in me because I am unchangeable, pure witness. So by mananam one realizes that. And that realization is called anubhuti. Now, after realizing that what I Atman is, after long thoughts and deep thoughts, that logic, yukti, you go on thinking. And then after that, one has to be established in that thought. That establishing in the thought of the Atman is called nididhyasana. Vedanta doesn't prescribe sitting and thinking in a quiet, like yoga, dhyana. That is not the path of Vedanta. Vedanta says you have to have so much conviction about yourself through mananam of what you have done, sravanam, mananam, or the deep thinking of the truth spoken by your guru or by the scripture. You are so much convinced that you are always aware of your true nature. You are never deviated by that. Swami, one brahmachari salil, so he was asked by Swami Shantanandaji, Holy Mother's disciple, that always do japam. Whatever you do, always do japam. So he used to go out for something, then buying this, doing this, he forgot. And when he came, Shantanandaji used to ask, what are you doing japam while going, while buying, while coming? He said, no, I forgot. He said one or two times like that. After that, before he went, go there, have something, some chore. Then he used to smile, and he also smiled that remember to do japam, remember God. After that practicing, Brahmachari Salil, his very senior monk now, he himself said that after that I had the practice of remembering God all the time, doing everything. That is called nididhyasana. That is called knowing God from the bhakti sense, knowing the self, thinking of the self on the jnana sense. It is same thing. What we call bhakti and jnana, as Sri Ramakrishna always said so clearly, where jnana takes, there bhakti takes you. So bhakti also will say, all jnana will say, always be aware of your true self, which is not dependent on anything. It is independent, it is bliss, it is ever there. So never changing. You will always remembering that in all interaction. Prasyan, srinvan, sprisan, jigran, asnan, gachan, swapan, swasan, pralapan, visrijan, grinnan, unmishan, nimishan, napi. Like that, in all the phases, indriyani, indriyarteshu, vartanta, iti dharayan. While seeing, walking, thinking, eating, all the time that person is aware that I am doing nothing, then who is doing that? This is all senses doing. Karma yoga, this karma indriya is walking, karmendriya is handling, holding. This all hand and feet, limbs doing. I am doing nothing. This indriya is doing on the something object to hold. It holds the path to travel. It travels. So that is indriya artha. Indriya artha is vishaya, on the vishaya. And the eye is pashyan. The eye see the object. It moves on the object on its indriya artha. That is the sight. Object is always eyes are interested on sight. But what is my role? I do nothing. Naiva kinchit karomi. I do nothing. That is the awareness a jnani will have. And that awareness is called nididhyasana. Establishing oneself in that awareness that I am not among these. This all is the play of senses, sense organs, and karmendriya and jnanendriya among the sense objects. I do nothing. Like Vyasadeva saying, give me food, he said. He ate a lot, and after that he prayed to Yamuna, Yamune, if I have not eaten, then please part yourself and give us the way. And really Yamuna divided into two, like the like that story of that Red Sea being divided in the Moses story. It divided into two. Gopis thought, this fellow just ate in front of me all the butter and milk and yogurt that we had, all he finished. Now he says, I have not eaten, and the Yamuna also complies to that. Yes, he has not eaten. Then who ate? Vyasadeva, man of knowledge, knows that he is not eating. It is all this, the process, this body is eating. Body is not he. the process of eating is not concerned to him. So that is called nididhyasana. Sravana, manana and nididhyasana. Nididhyasana is not dhyana. Dhyana is yoga dhyana. According to yoga, you sit down and then you try to focus and concentrate your mind on the object of meditation. Here the object of nididhyasana is your true self. It is not to be thought of something, but to be aware that I am not the doer. I am not the doer, I am not the enjoyer. So who enjoyed that food? It is a mind enjoyed. Tongue enjoyed, and I am neither the mind, mano, buddhi, ahankara, chittani, naham. I am neither the mind nor the tongue. So I have not enjoyed, I have done nothing. So like that is the nididhyasana, always immersed in that. After talking lot many verses about nididhyasana to the disciple, now Guru gives the instruction how you should live, what you should do. From verse 471 that we are continuing. Last time we read verse 473 in which it is said, Samadhina sadhu vinischalatma vinischalatmana pasyatma tattvam sphuta bhoda chakshusa nissankshayam samyak avekshitaschet shruta padartho na punar vikalpate. Shruta padartha, that is what you have heard, the truth. What is the truth? I am Atma Brahma, myself in Brahman, Tattvamasi. I am that individual infinite reality that you have heard. Now that person is not moved from that. Na punar vikalpate, that doubt doesn't come by the process of nididhyasana. You are so firmly established in that knowledge that if someone says, no, that is all thought, that is hallucination, someone taught you and you believe that. It is not about belief. Vedanta doesn't speak about faith and belief. It says about more emphasis on the work of intellect, on the thought. It is very logical, very rational philosophy that has been made practical in experience. That is the speciality of Vedanta. So you hear the truth, now you think for yourself and remove the doubts. If doubts come, then there will be no nididhyasana. So mananam will remove all the doubts. You go on thinking, is that I am not this body, I am Atma, that time is the mananam. Tattvamasi, that infinite reality in which everything is contained and everything, this whole creation is contained in that reality. That is never changing, creation changes. And that I am, tattvamasi. That how does it, I feel I'm a small individual self. So mananam will make us feel that. Once you get the glimpse of your true self, that is not enough. Now comes nididhyasana, getting established, getting firmly established in that. Sthita pragya is very much needed. Otherwise, if you have the glimpse, that glimpse will go. Again, we'll be like that parrot who says Rama, Rama. But when cat comes, then he says tya, tya. So, like that, if we are not established, we will deviate from the truth. That's why, to this person, it says, na vikalpyate, na punar vikalpyate. What type of samadhina sadhu vinischalatmana. His atman, his mind is vinischala, nischala, not deviating, not wavering, always firm. What type of firm? Vishesha rupena, nishesha rupena. Very too many, nischala, vinischala, vishesha rupena, nischala. Is truly fixed on the truth. That comes through nididhyasana, that Shankara told in so many verses. Hundreds of verses he said that, more than 100 verses. So, nissangsayam samyak avekshitaschet. So by that you get the full whole get established in nissangsaya without any doubt. You are established in the truth. That is the goal of the knowledge, path of knowledge. Now from this 472, he is saying the teacher is guiding the student how you should practice, how you should live. Now verse 474 that we'll do today. 473 was done earlier. Swasya vidya bandh sambandh mokshat satya jnana nanda rupatma labdhau shastram yuktir deshi kokti pramanam chanta siddha swanubhuti pramanam. Now he goes on saying there are the proof of the truth. What are the proof? It is swasya avidya bandha sambandha moksha. It is your personal experience, personal realization. It cannot be known by others. Sometimes we ask, are there any person who is jivan mukta? So if there are any, it doesn't help us much. That we say only to be confirmed that there can be jivan mukta. But another person is jivan mukta, that will not really affect me. Little we find the sadhu sangha, satsanga, whatever effect is there. But satsanga is not the real realization. Satsanga is for the inspiration. Yes, jivan mukti can be attained. That much you realize the truth is the Atman is the truth. That only inspiration comes through satsanga. But realization we all have to attain ourselves. That's why swasya avidya bandha sambandha mokshat. Now your avidya bandha sambandha, you are bound with avidya, ignorance. That is the root cause of all our problem. Avidya. Avidya is ignorance. Ignorance of what? Ignorance of ourselves. We don't know ourselves. We think we know everything in the world. Rocket science also we know. How many days, how to reach Mars we know. But we don't know ourselves. There is vidya for everything external. But swasya avidya. You have your own avidya. Now this avidya of ourself has to be removed. And this avidya bandha sambandha mokshat. For that, to be freed from the bandhana of avidya sambandha, relationship with avidya, with ignorance, the considering ourselves as this material body and material mind, that has to be, for that what to be done? Mokshat, for that, sat, and what will happen when you become freed from avidya, ignorance, what will happen? Then what will happen is, Atma Rupatma Labdhav, you will gain the knowledge of Atma Rupa. What is your true form? What is your true nature? You will know that. And what is that? What is the nature of our true self? Satya Jnana Ananda Rupa. That is the nature of Atma. It is Satya, it is Jnana, it is Ananda Rupa. Satya, we all know, Satya is that which always remains same. We say, tell the truth, means you don't make it, it should be, it happened, it is the truth. For a small saying also, the truth shall remain always truth. It will not, if you concoct some story, that will change under pressure. Police will find out what is the truth. You say, no, I'm saying the truth. The police takes you and he inquires things with various methods and your whatever you said changes. Why does it change? Because it was not truth. That's why it changes. So satya, truth is, doesn't change at all. It always remains same. That is the definition of satya. So, Atman is Satya. It never changes. It is always same. It doesn't neither grows, nor modifies, nor degenerates, nor becomes stronger, nor becomes weak. It is always same. Since when it is same? Since when created? No. Whatever is created has to undergo degeneration. Whatever is created has to undergo change. Atman is not created, that's why it doesn't undergo change. Created thing, created universe will have to go sadvikara. Jayate, asti, vardhate, viparinamate, apakshiyate, nasyati. Everything created has to be that. It is created, it gets born, then there is existence. After it is created, the existence is there, it's seen, it is present, then it grows or changes, grows, matures.
Everything like sun, moon, galaxy, plant, animal, human body, everything undergoes this. First it is created, jayate, it's born. Then after being born it exists, existence and birth. With the birth comes existence. With the creation comes existence. Jayate asti, then it vardhate, then it matures, it grows, gets maturity. With our life, with plant life, any life, with any heavenly body. Sun created from nebula and then it started creating the stars and then slowly it really, star is formed. Now this star, when this maturity, vardhate, then viparinamate, final maturity has come, growth has finished. Now it has fully matured. Then after maturation, what will happen? Then viparinamate apakshiyate, then slowly degeneration, slowly changes, slowly weakening, everything becomes old. Sun also becomes old, galaxy also becomes old, universe will also become old, like that. After it becomes old, then it is nasyati, then it will finish, destroyed. What is destruction? Going back to the form from which it is created. Nothing, it is change, recycling. The death is recycling. From all evolution of this universe, there will be involution. Whole universe came from Big Bang. Again, it will become involved into very small, minute something, that which we do not even can think. So, again there will be evolution, again there will be creation. Whatever is created undergoes changes. Atman is not created, the Self is not created, our true nature is not created. That's why it does not undergo change. It is always same. It has no birth and no death. Then what is this birth and death? Swami Vivekananda very nicely describes last Wednesday we were discussing. Swamiji says, this birth and death is the story, as if we are reading life story of the person. What we say, I, this body, this person, we give name, we have identified with this person, and then we start reading the life of that person. And who is reading? Atman is reading. And Atman and this person are different. And this Atman somehow identifies with that actor, and he says, the actor was born, actor became old, he fought with that, he won this prize, he passed that, what a wonderful life he had, happy life, and that person deceived, and the Atman became this person became angry. But this is not the person that he is studying, it is just the character we are reading, like we see a person's life in the movie. And somehow we get identified with that actor. And that actor become old, we think, oh, feel sad. Actor is given punishment by some villain comes, we feel very bad, he's torturing. But actor is actor and I am the witness, I'm just seeing that. Like that exactly is our this body-mind complex, which we somehow are studying. That one page is there, we are reading this life. And after reading the life, when he was born, he grew, then he went on to deathbed and he died. He died, then the page turned. After that again we do not leave this person. Then that person went to heaven and they went with God. And that still the second page starts about that person. First person finished and then forgotten. But we are still reading the life story of this person. Went to heaven and was among the angels, having fantastic time, and there's another, you go on reading that, whatever happened there. After that, you finish that. What happens then? That person gets rebirth. Then it becomes, suppose it becomes another person, he's born in somewhere, in other country, some in South America, and he's born as a woman, man was there, he's born as a woman, and this now again, you identify with this another character because you are reading the life. This reading the page after page goes on, and we identify with this character, with this actor, and think, I am that. This is avidya. This identifying with the character. Why that character, why that actor is? That is what I think that I am. That is just the actor that is happening. And we are reading this book by book, page by page. That Swami Vivekananda nicely describes that. after reading a lot, how big the life of this person, we don't know. But different forms come, different roles come, and we always think, I am that. And finally, time come when the book will finish. You finish the book, no more reading, then you understand, I was reading. That's called mukti. That is called mukti, but not after death. After that we start reading another page, after rebirth another page, again death another page, like they go on reading the book, very voluminous book, this is never ending, many pages, many chapters. That Swami Vivekananda says. So who goes after that is not that I go, but my identification with particular jiva, that again transmigrates because of my identification. I don't realize that I'm just reading a book of this person. Like this actor in front of me, I am witness, that is not there. That is the avidya. So avidya has to go. This avidya causes bondage. That's why it says, avidya bandha sambandha mokshat, for the purpose of freedom from this bondage with avidya. When avidya comes, when you forget who you are, that is avidya, ignorance, dark. See, we don't remain in dark, just don't forget. Immediately another thing happens when avidya comes, asmita comes, I-ness comes. I, that is different from you, different from he or she, different from it. That's called asmita, ego. When avidya came, true nature gone, then ego comes. Ego comes, then as soon as you are separate from the whole universe, then two more things comes. That is raga and dvesha, like and dislike. These are all bondages, all binds us. Bondage is suffering. Suffering, that's every bondage, every attachment will bring us suffering. Why suffering? Because if attachment gives us happiness, to be with our relative, to be with our money, to be with our good health, if it brings us happiness, those all are changing phenomenon. We have to separate from those whom we love. They will either go to different city or we will go to from this world. Every change, every separation will bring suffering. And with this raga and dvesa, so this bondage and caused by this like and dislike. You like someone, you want to hold on to that. You dislike someone, you hate that. It both are great bondages, like and dislike both. Hatred and this attachment, both are bondages. Then what about love? Love is also bondage? Love is not bondage. But what we call love, is bondage. We don't know to love at all. Attachment, we say, is love. Those we love, we have to be with us. I love money, so hold on money. I love my son, hold on, he should be always with me. Like that we say love. Love, real love is the unity of the being. Real love is not bondage. If love brings us bondage, attachment, that is not real love. Love has to free us. It is the thing that frees us, gives us knowledge, gives us freedom. So, then satya jnananda rupa atma labdhau. Then that atman is attained of the nature of satya jnana ananda, that rupa atman labdhau. So how would it be done? Shastram yuktir deshi kokti pramanam. Through the proof, you have to try for that. What is the proof of the truth that we are that self? We are not this individualized being, this ego-fed person, but we are infinite, all-pervading reality. How do we know? What is the proof? Proof is three proofs. What are the three proofs? Shastram, scriptures. Those who have realized, they have told this. Shastram. Veda hametam purusham mahantam. I have known that great, grand, gorgeous, glorious being. Veda hametam purusham mahantam aditya varnam tamasa parastam. Beyond all darkness, beyond all ignorance, beyond all bondage, aditya varnam, like blazing sun, full of light, full of joy, full of freedom. That is that glorious being. I have known that. Who is that being? His own self, our own self, Atman. Tameva viditva ati mrityumeti. You want to be free from death? Afraid of death? Know that glorious being. Without that, nanya pantha. There is no other way for getting freed from the fear of death. So you have to know that glorious being beyond all darkness and like the blazing sun, full of freedom and knowledge, beyond all doubts and suffering and darkness. Know that, that only happened. That is Shastra. Shastra says that. That must be true. You have to have, here you can say, little faith. But our faith of Shastra is not other faith like other things. The faith of Shastra is until we realize. Faith, our Vishwas, or faith is, Shastra says, so I should be able to realize this. That is faith. Because it is said, that's why I don't care that it must be true. Not that. When it is said so, I must realize this. Faith is for that purpose. It is called Vishwasa. Then Shastra Pramana, one Pramana came. But it is not firm, you have not changed. You know only Shastra. Then Yukti, then Shastra is the hearing, you know that. Then Yukti, then you go on thinking, yeah, really, there can be some being that glorious, myself is so glorious. I go on thinking, I am not this body, I suffer from so much, I get disturbed. Yes, I get disturbed because of my mind. People who are like me, they don't disturb by some hearing something, some insulting words, they can digest that. I am not this. We can be overcome, disturbance can be overcome. People in the facing death also, wherever they are so happy, peaceful, and they don't worry for death, they know that then there is the thing, then you go on thinking on that, deeply thinking. So I am real, then you realize, mananam, doubt, pros and cons. You go on doing and then you realize. Then when you have now understood the truth, then you do Nididhyasana. You try to be always established in that reality. Yes, I am that. Tattvamasi. I am that. I am not this body. And that realization, all this has to be done through Yukti. And what is another, this Yukti? One is Shastra. Another is Deshikokti Pramanam. Another Praman, he said, Deshika Ukti. Have you heard that verse on Shankara? Bhava Shankara Deshika Me Saranam. What is Deshika? Deshika comes from Disha. Disha Nirdesha. Who showed you direction? Which side to go? Which side to move? What is to do? Oh Shankara Deshika, that is Guru. Deshika means Guru. Shankara Jagat Guru Shankaracharya. Oh Shankara, please take me in your refuge. Bhava Shankara Deshika Me Saranam. So like that, Deshikokti Pramanam. Deshika says, that is also Praman. Often what happens is that what we hear from the Shastras, or we read the Shastra, if you go and take the book of Upanishad and start reading, it becomes extremely difficult to understand. Just by reading Upanishad, to really go deep into the meaning of Upanishad becomes very difficult. We understand these scriptures when it is explained by the teacher, by the guru. And guru says something and then we follow that, then we realize that truth. So Deshikokti is another pramanam, guru's words. Shastra Guru Vakya Vishwasa, that comes in one of the sadhana, that the person of that who practices Vedanta, he has to have Shastra Guru Vakya Vishwasa. You have to have faith in the Shastra and in the words of the Guru. Guru is one who has realized the truth and he can explain or she can explain the thing. So, Deshikokti Pramanam, Chanta Siddha, and what is Anta Siddha Swanubhuti Pramanam? There is one more Pramana. That is Swanta Siddha. That is inside you realize anubhuti. It is anubhuti, your own experience. Now it is the firm conviction that it is what Guru said, what Shastra said, what I thought is really true. There is no doubt about that. But you have to understand it has to come to yourself, not because Guru said, but it has to come by your own thinking, by your own logic. Sri Ramakrishna, some person were talking to Sri Ramakrishna, and Sri Ramakrishna was trying to explain the thing, and that person was asking question again and again. Is that so? How it can be so? And his friend had come who knew Sri Ramakrishna. He said, why you are arguing with him when he has said? Just agree. Say, just keep quiet. Just accept that. Sri Ramakrishna said, what? Being accepting something without being convinced? Because it won't last long. You accept half-hearted, half-doubt, the doubt will creep again. So, don't accept anything without being convinced. That's what is called anubhuti. So be convinced and then accept. That's what Sri Ramakrishna. He always, whoever tasted Sri Ramakrishna, he never was sad. One of his own disciple, young man, was doubting on Sri Ramakrishna, where he goes at night. And he was standing there, and Sri Ramakrishna came from his nature's call. And then that disciple felt very bad. He thought, Sri Ramakrishna says something, does something. And Sri Ramakrishna understood, oh, you are here testing me, where have I gone? So you did very good. You should test, always like that. He was not angry. You rascal, you are testing me like that. You have doubt on me. I am a guru, nothing. You have done very good. You should test, like the money changer test the coins, whether it is a counterfeit coin or it's a real coin. Like that you should change, you should test your guru. So whenever he was tested, he never was angry. So Swami Vivekananda tested him. He said, I cannot touch money, coin. I feel very like the scorpion white. And is that so? Then what Swami Vivekananda did in Narendranath, he put a coin under his bed. Under his bed, not even touched. And Sri Ramakrishna came from out, sat on the bed, just below his cushion was that coin. He cried, shouted, and just jumped out and said, what happened? Just check, what is there inside? Something be there. Then they found out there was a coin. Now he looked here, he saw, he knew that Narendranath did this. But never a single word, oh, you are doubting me, what I say is not right. He say, happy. Doubt the thing and then you will find the truth. Doubt has to go through experiment, through experience. So that is what always the teachers explain that. Siddha Svanubhuti Pramanam. That best praman is Anubhuti. Shruti, Yukti, Anubhava. That is three things has to come. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. Nididhyasana will lead to Anubhava. So that is the final. When you have realized and understood yourself, now all doubt will go away. Then there is no doubt that I am that self-revealing Atman, that glorious Atman, that like the sun, blazing sun and beyond all darkness, that thing will come, will be realized by yourself. And that has to be done. Atma labdhihi, attaining the truth of myself. You have to understand yourself. That's what 474. Now next verse says, bandho mokshasya triptisya chinta rogya kshudadaya svenaiva vedya yas jnanam paresham anumanikam. This when someone has realized, and we know there is a God-realized person, always doubting whether there is God-realization is there. That doesn't help. We have to experience ourselves. They say, taste of the pudding is in eating. Like the taste of the knowledge of reality is in acquiring that knowledge ourselves. Without acquiring other person realizing, it becomes no useful for us. So we have to try to realize ourselves. Like here it says, Shankaracharya gives the list of things that is personal experience. And it said, like that should be the experience of the Atman, knowledge of the Atman. What are the personal experience? Bandha, that bond is. The bondage is your own personal experience. We cannot say, one cannot say about other that person is very bound. We may guess, but we cannot definitely say that person is bound. Sometimes this guess about others become very wrong. We often try to think about others as we are and try to bring that person at our level and think that person is that. That is the so much mistake we do. Bandha is yourself understanding how much you are bound, how much you have bondage, you know, others won't know. Moksha, like that is the freedom. You have really attained the freedom or you have not, you cannot say, others cannot say that. It is your own experience. Tripti, satisfaction. Satisfaction, how much you are satisfied, that is also your own experience, personal experience. Shankaracharya gives the list of personal experience, you see, in elaboration. Chinta, always anxiety, worry. By saying you can guess that person seems to be restless, disturbed, but you cannot really understand what is the depth of disturbance and restlessness of that person. Only we can guess that person is not getting sleep or waking up. Swami Vivekananda was walking at 1:30 p.m. at night. Then they thought he's feeling some suffering. He's not peaceful. What happened? They saw, I felt that there is a lot of many people having undergone a great suffering. And next day it was found in the newspaper, there is an earthquake in South America. Swami Vivekananda was in Belur Math. He could feel that many people suffering. When you have that identification, your soul connecting with all souls, then you feel others suffering. And sometimes in Sri Ramakrishna case, two boatmen were fighting with each other on Ganga. Sri Ramakrishna was near his room, quite far away from Ganga. And he was seeing intently what is happening. One person slapped another person's back. Sri Ramakrishna cried out and Hridaya came and said, Uncle, what happened? Oh, that person, he beat him so hard, you see. And he saw where? And he saw there was a mark of palm in his own body. That's how it happens when we are unified in our thought with others. We really feel others suffering. Mother and son. Son is having, child is having some problem. Mother feels because of that love. That love, unification, unity, that happened. Swami Vivekananda also was that. But who will know that? Little people understand, but what was the depth of Swamiji's suffering? Only he knew. When they asked, then you know that has happened. So that is the chinta. Arogya. How much you are healthy, that is also your own self-realization. It is also, you cannot say, doctors can say, but arogya feeling is also your own realization. Kshudadaya, kshudha, khut means hunger. I am hungry or not, that I will know. Other person cannot know I am hungry or not. It's very personal experience. Swe naiva vedya. These are all known by oneself alone, not by others. That's what Shankara says. Gives the list and says, Swe naiva vedya. Yas jnanam paresham anumanikam. So others don't understand at all. Paresham, others, anumanikam. They can guess, they can infer, but they will not fully know. Like that is the realization of the self. We can guess that other person has realized, but that is also of little significance to us. We have to realize the self by ourselves. Otherwise, it has no significance to us. Paresham anumanikam. So, anumanikam. Svenaiva vedya yajganam. That is called knowledge, is that when you understand yourself. Similarly, we have to know the truth ourselves. That is the inspiration Shankara tries to give, inspires us and say that you should understand your real nature. You identify with something else which you are not, and then you suffer for useless suffering, which you should not suffer. Because of ignorance comes the bondage, and because of the bondage, identification with anatma, and then you suffer. Anatma suffers and you think, I am suffering. So just little, if you could get knowledge by little practice, by little thought, By little hearing the scriptures and meditating on that, anunididhyasana on that, you could be freed from all suffering, all duality, all ignorance, and be established in bliss, in happiness. Happiness, what type of? That never changes. Nothing can make that happiness gone, diluted. Nothing can change that happiness. Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother said, I never saw Sri Ramakrishna sad. He was always joyful, always joyful. So when he was cancer, then also he was so much teaching people, come, glow was there, little better he feels, goes and gives teaching. Never he stopped talking. Dr. Sarkar said, you should stop talking because it aggravates your thing. Who listens what? Whoever comes, aspirant comes, he went on speaking, guiding, talking about God, and always full of joy was Sri Ramakrishna. Never could that joy be taken away. That is the sign of realization. So Shankara says there is so much of thing that is in you. Sri Ramakrishna was also going by a carriage, and he saw, he was looking here and there, and he looked through the window, he took out his head and saw people walking on the street. He was going by horse carriage. And went back and says, oh, this Calcutta people, all their minds are fixed on their body. They have no inclination for spirituality at all. And they all are suffering a lot in this bondage with the body, identification with the body. They all are suffering. And Sri Ramakrishna was very anxious to remove their suffering. And said, I have to go, my life is not long. But said to Holy Mother, you will have to take charge and remove their suffering. Holy Mother said, what can I do? I am a village woman, unlettered. Sri Ramakrishna said, no, you will represent the motherhood of God. What I have done, you have to do much more than what I have done. That's what Sri Ramakrishna said. So all this realized soul, Shankara says in the Vivekachudamani, this is like the spring season. This great realized soul are like the spring that comes, that they have gone beyond ignorance, and then they help others to take away, they help others to go away from ignorance, remove their ignorance. How do they do? Just by being there. Like the spring comes, it doesn't have to work anything. Spring comes and everything changes just by its association. So realized soul, by being there, they also take others across the ignorance. And how do? They inspire. By seeing them, we feel that it can be done, it is achievable. This person has done. By their talk, by their aura, by their thoughts, they inspire. That's what is called satsanga. So that's what Shankara also says, having themselves cross the ignorance, they make others, help others to cross ignorance. That is the sign of realized person. So this much we will do today. If you have any question, you will ask. Otherwise, the Shankara says, more than asking, it is all about thinking, all about being aware of our true self. There is nothing much to ask. It is clearly said, it is ignorance that makes us feel that we are this individualized being, ego, but that is ignorance, so remove that idea and know yourself to be infinite self. So it's all about, more about practice, and more about awareness, then the question, what is the question, should be there. So, thank you very much. Yes?
You said about Guru's word, we should take it as a faith. And then, but Guru Maharaj is saying, there is nothing wrong in you, ponder into that and then say
that. Desikokti. Yeah. That is also Praman. What Guru said is Praman. What Guru said, it explains what the Shastras say. Sometimes Shastra can't fully understood, so Guru we understand. That's why when Guru Maharaj says, don't accept because I said, then ask question, pariprasna.
Pariprasna.
Yeah, pariprasna, clarify that. But what Guru has said is the truth. If you don't understand, it is you have to question and then clarify the thing. But what Guru said is the proof.
That faith, if faith is there, Maharaj, for example, I know Rosen Parasartamol will cure my fever. So why should I go on, go deep into it, okay, what is the combination, why, Rosen I take, my fever will go. Like that, I go with my Guru's word, I'll be fine. So.
That is true, but that person was not understanding. Idea has to be clear, as Swami Vivekananda said. You may say 1,000 times, but until I realize that you are incarnation, I will not accept. No, not you say. All may say that you are incarnation, but until I realize, I will not say. That is some people feel that way. Some people don't have to do Sri Ramakrishna, so much faith in that. They say Sri Ramakrishna said that can be nothing else, like Girish Ghosh. Girish Ghosh. That's why Swami Vivekananda himself says, if I had faith like you, I doubt and clear. So here also, Guru Deshi Kokti is what Deshika has spoken. He will speak the Shastras. Speak the Shastras. So he will clear the thing. If you don't understand, don't doubt Guru's words, but you are always asked to ask Guru to clarify the thing. Guru, I don't really understand this. That can be done. I don't accept, you will not say, I don't understand. Can you make it clear? That is pariprasna. That is pariprasna.
One question. So as per the Guru, but as we can see nowadays, like a so-called so many Gurus exist, if this is the thing which is being told, like to follow and faith on Guru, that's what people are doing, and then following like XYZ Gurus, and they are following like, you know, here and there, and the basically worldly things. So this is also one question.
Yeah,
how
in fact...
How to recognize the right Guru?
In fact, in Upanishad itself it is said, Andhe naiva niyamana yathanda. They themselves have not realized the truth. You make anyone Guru without any having faith, without any understanding, go in the glamour, and then they themselves have not realized, how will they help you to realize? So Andhe naiva niyamana. Blind person, and you, another blind person, he is leading. So where will they go? The blind person cannot show him the way. So, but the thing is, that's why you have to be, that it comes, you see. If you have, now why people follow Gurus? Many people just want very little things. How will I get job? How will I get this? Like those things, simple things, and go here and there. Why Guru? You go to the astrologers. They become the Guru, and they will give you, how will I get job, my job is not getting. So you go and they say, wear this ring. If you want to be trapped like this, then what you will do? You get trapped in the people saying. Anything that you want to hold on to save yourself. So like that is the thing, you say he is Guru and you go. Something good people may find, which we may not find. People may like some people, that is there. But if they are led towards the wrong side, then that is really bad. There is no using their own brain. No yukti is there. No pariprasna is there. I am going to right path. That intellect is not purified. They are very other considerations are there. So, person has to himself or herself find out whether this person is genuine or not. If you don't find the genuineness of the person, it will be cheated everywhere. So that is being cheated. So that person has to find out about the genuinity of the teacher. There are some things that the teacher is, Swami Vivekananda says clearly, they don't go after name and fame. They don't go after money. They don't go after glories. So whether the teacher that you follow has all this weakness or not, wanting to make many disciples, and wanting to be rich and famous, and like that. If you have that, then you have to doubt the thing. shanti shanti shantihi harihi om tat sat shri ram krishna arpanamastu jananim saradam devim ram krishnam jagad gurum pad padme tayo shritva pranamami muhur muhur.